Hey again on everyone, Páirtí Quinlan, Dublin West representative for the National Party. We're just out here today on Kildare Street, just outside Dáil Éireann. We're going to submit the petition in relation to Minister Roger Gorman and his white paper on direct provision and hopefully get the ball rolling to get that scrapped. I'm just going to give you a quick read of the letter here that we've prepared and then we're going to go submit the petition. Chocta Dála. This letter contains the results of a petition collected in the Dublin West constituency, which directly appealed to constituents to voice their opinion on the white paper issued by Minister Roger O'Gorman for a reform of the direct provision system, published the 26th of February 2021. The most salient contents of the Minister's proposals were Phase 1, which will last not to 4 months. Accommodation will be afforded in a reception and integration centre, which will include the building of 6 reception and integration centres. Claimants will be entitled to a daily expense allowance of €38.80, emergency needs payment and back-to-school clothing and footwear allowance, able to apply to open an Irish bank account and be able to apply for an Irish driving licence. Phase 2. After 4 months in a reception and integration centre and still awaiting approval for their asylum application, claimants will be able to avail of accommodation provided either by approved housing bodies or by NGOs and private tenancies, which will be paid for by the state. Applicants at this stage will also avail of the Department of Social Protection weekly payment on the same basis as Irish residents, child benefit, emergency needs payments and a work and family payment. Access to third level education. Asylum applicants will be able to avail of the SUSE grant scheme and the international student charge for the PLC courses, which stands at €3,600, has been waived for applicants who have established labour market access, which they can apply for after 6 months in the new system. During the petition drive, which was spearheaded by the National Party, 3,692 constituents from a broad geographic range within the electoral areas of Dublin West were engaged with, of which 1,981 signed the petition, which asked ministers to reject Minister O'Gorman's white paper and instead favour the policy of House the Irish. A clear majority, 54%, therefore demonstrated their rejection of the minister's proposal and also signed their support for the alternative House the Irish policy. The findings of this petition clearly demonstrate the fiction of Minister O'Gorman's claim that his constituents were fully supportive of his measures on direct provision. Dublin West constituents are fully aware of the failing of the current direct provision system, particularly the revolving door of orders to leave followed by lodgements of appeal, which creates a scenario where the system is purposefully overcrowded. This has prompted such preposterous and deranged adjustments to be made. It is clear as to why the Irish people have never been asked directly whether they agree with these changes to direct provision before meeting petitioners from the National Party. Minister O'Gorman will continue to lament and lay claim that he has the people's full support when in fact he does not. We ask that deputies reflect upon the findings of this petition, particularly those deputies representing the Dublin West constituency. The National Party will campaign for Minister O'Gorman's proposals to be scrapped and will continue to advocate for an alternative House the Irish policy, a policy which has the support of 54% of the electorate whom we met in Dublin West. And we're going to go submit that petition now, folks. So there you have it, folks. Back again to the Dáil with another petition on the public's behalf, calling for the resignation of Minister Roger O'Gorman and for his bad policies to be binned in full. I know the definition of insanity is to do the same thing over and over again and expecting a different result. To be honest, I don't expect a different result, but we are sending the people inside Dáil Éireann a message that the Irish people will not go quiet into the night. And one thing that we need to remember as well is no matter how many times we have to come back here submitting public petitions, eventually we're going to end up inside Dáil Éireann and we're going to be writing pro-Irish legislation that is going to put the Irish people first inside their own homeland, and we will hold that cohort of traitors inside Dáil Éireann, keeping our seats warm, to account. Yes, you're right.